Hello and welcome. Please enjoy this short readiness video on Azure Database for PostgreSQL.
Hi, Sai. How you doing?
Good, Sanjay. How are you?
I'm great. And I know it's going to be a surprise, okay, for me because this is going to be a fun. I'm looking forward to this particular demo, which I have that you're going to talk about. So let's see what I'm going to talk about.
Yeah. So today I'm here to talk about how do we build geospatial applications with Azure Database for Postgres. So yeah.
All right. Let's get started.
Awesome. So Postgres has very rich geospatial feature sets, and this is because of the PostGIS extension. So the PostGIS extension lets you create and represent various geospatial constructs such as latitudes, longitudes, geometries, intersections, polygons, etc. at the database layer.
Okay.
And what Azure Database Postgres does is, along with supporting all of these like cool features that community Postgres supports, it gives you the ability to complement your geospatial database with tools such as Power BI to solve mission-critical hard business problems.
Oh, wow.
Awesome. So today, what we would be doing, Sanjay, is we'd go through a business scenario of site selection. So site selection is a very common real-world scenario across like multiple industries. Say you take the retail industry, right? So you're a retail store and you want to figure out where do you want to start a retail company and you want to figure out where do you want to start your retail stores.
So you want to open a new store and you're trying to decide the site where
you should open it.
Exactly. That is one. The second is you're a scooter company and you want to decide where do I want to place my charging stations, right? So there are multiple scenarios like that. And today we would be focusing, just as an example, the second one, which is I am a scooter company and I want to decide where do I want to put my charging stations, right? So here there is a Forbes article. It's a fantastic article and you should go through, which talks about what is the major expense for a scooter company. It says that the major expense is the nightly charging, which the company needs to do for its scooters.
Yes.
And the major contribution of that is actually the scooter company just moving those scooters to the charging stations and just bringing them back.
Of course.
Right?
Because I remember renting one of those in Lisbon this summer.
Exactly.
Right? So people just leave them where they are. And they don't
Exactly. So it's super critical, you know, to have these charging stations in the right locations so that they reduce the cost. And as you said, right, like here is the SWOT analysis, which shows why this market is so heavy. I mean, there are a lot of competitors, a lot of companies doing this.
Yeah.
And then if you observe, right, in the objectives, one of the most important objective is to minimize the expenses.
Yes.
And for that, deciding the sites for your charging stations is super critical. Right? So today's problem, the big question is, where are the best places to put scooter charging centers for a scooter company?
Awesome.
Right? So let's learn how Azure Database for Postgres with like multiple community tools solves this problem.
Okay.
Right? So in solving this question, right, so there are many factors you need to keep in mind. One is population, right? So do you want to place these charging stations in a location with high population?
Of course.
Next is proximity to public transportation. So you don't want to have these charging stations close to subways, right? Because typically people prefer to use public transportation than using the scooters.
Okay.
The third is around income, right? So if you are in the higher bracket, then you might not prefer to use scooters, whereas if you are in the lower bracket, you might not afford to use the scooters. So that is also an important factor. And last but not the least, obviously crime rates, right? So you don't want to have charging stations in areas with large crime rates. Right? So these are all the factors we need to keep in mind in making this decision.
Okay.
Right? Let's see how Postgres with the community tools makes all of this simple. Right? So this is a big complicated task. And for today, we'll just take the New York City, which is a huge city. And it has close to 10,400 kilometers of streets. Right? And it has 43,000 intersections. So it's a lot.
Yeah.
And then this is a depiction of how it looks in the New York City. So all the red ones you see there, right? The red dots are street intersections.
Okay.
And then this is being displayed by a tool called QGIS. It's a tool that is available in the community,
okay,
used very predominantly in the geospatial industry. And under the covers, this QGIS is compatible with Postgres, and it's actually running a Postgres database under the covers.
Okay.
right? So let's consider the first factor of proximity to public transportation, right? On you don't want to have your charging stations close to subways, right? Because people would prefer public transportation, right? And let's take that factor and let's see how we reduce and filter all of these intersections, right? So what we'll do is we'll run a simple delete command, as you're seeing on the screen, which deletes all the intersections that are at a radius of 500 meters at the subway stations.
Yes.
Right. So if you see the delete command, the interesting piece is getting a little technical is it does a geospatial join. So it, that is needed to figure out like these locations that are close to like subway regions, and then you delete it from the entire like intersections table, right?
What is a geospatial join? Is so that on after on STW?
Exactly. Okay. So that's where you have the geospatial join. You have STD within, right?
Okay.
That is a construct which performs the join, and if you see, that's all PostGIS in Azure Database for PostgreSQL,
okay.
Right? So once I do that delete, if you see, the green ones are the subway stations,
okay.
Right? And the red ones, which are closer to the green ones, are now disappeared, and then you see like just like plain colors, right?
Yes.
So we did some amount of filtering with one factor, which is proximity to public transportation. Now we'll go a step higher, and let's use Power BI, right? And Power BI here, if you see, is compatible with like Postgres again. It supports all the PostGIS constructs, and Power BI has something called as GeoJSON, and that is compatible with the geospatial features as well for Postgres, right? And if you see, there is a table there which shows all the factors which we talked about, and then the one in the red, which is the site priority, is a score we are generating which weights all of these like factors and generates like a normalized score. And this also can be done with Power BI, by the way, right? And the one in the green you see is the neighborhood ID, right? And here what we are doing is we are ranking the neighborhoods with the highest priority.
Okay.
So we are taking the 10 neighborhoods with highest priority. And then in the next step, what we'll do is we'll delete all the intersections that are not close to these neighborhoods, right?
Yeah.
And let's go to QGIS again, and this is the delete like operation if you see.
Yeah.
Again, it does a complex geospatial join and a simple like delete query, right?
Yeah.
And then here if we see like we are taking those neighborhood IDs, and then we are deleting them, we are deleting all the regions that are not close to these neighborhoods, right?
Of course.
And finally, after running this delete, here is how it would look.
At least you have lesser options now. You can breathe and
exactly.
think logically. You know?
Exactly. Yeah. So like a lot of filtering now, and then you have those red locations, and those are the ideal regions where you can have the charging station. So 95% of the filtering is done in a couple of minutes, right?
Okay.
So
where is Times Square in this?
So that's a great question. So I think Times Square is right in between because it's in Midtown.
Okay.
So I love that place. But
okay.
Yeah, awesome. So the summary is using PostGIS and Postgres, Azure Database for PostgreSQL, you can solve hard geospatial problems very easily.
Yes.
So feel free to, if there is a geospatial use case, go ahead and spin up a database using our PaaS offering and test it out. So.
Fantastic. Yep. So basically, we can, our customers and, of course, internal Microsoft folks as well, they can actually use Power BI with the whole Postgres and really make this magic happen.
Exactly, exactly.
Many, many thanks for this amazing scenario.
Awesome, Sanjay. Nice talking to you, sir. Yep.
Thanks for watching this short Azure Readiness video.